there seems to be like different categories of makerspaces. There's ones that focus on virtual reality. There's ones that focus on 3D making and 3D printing. And then there's ones that have like circuit building and circuit design. And I realized that we need a little bit of all of that. So it's sort of a hybrid of all of them. And we want to make it so that people can come in and work the space together and learn from each other as well.
My favorite piece of the technology was the hands. It would be interesting to be used in a classroom setting for, like, example, a lot of the introduction to engineering courses use AutoCAD. It's a three-dimensional modeling program. And if you're actually able to use your hands to interact with the model, it would help with the learning experience. I just enjoyed being able to experience all of the different technology, because this stuff, while it's not very common now, could be common in the future. And seeing it in its development and the early stages of it really provides a unique opportunity.
I think it's going to give them the opportunity to take these ideas that they have in their heads, or different things they want to improve on and design, and actually test it out, try it out, see if their product and see if their idea actually can become reality. And then see if you get really interested in it, then you can go and talk to the labs and the centers and the different groups that we have here on campus, and they can get you more involved in it. This is that sort of first step to get you introduced to things and get you some hands-on experience.